And then our front.
Sure.
We wanted to always move the flagpole because the flag doesn't stay on. So someday when we were going to get to that, if we could remove that as well as then paint at the same time, so we don't have to paint again if we want to remove the flag thing.
Right.
But that front needs painting too, because there's different things that we had to.
Can we go look at it real quick?
Sure.
So you want a quote basically for painting this in?
Or any kind of repair. As you can tell, there's like some rot, but I don't think this side is rotted like the other side, but it's just flaking, I believe.
Sure. So is it just the trim boards, or you want the middle painted? A quote
this
for,
whole, and I guess for lack of, I don't know what the word is for this whole end. You call it a gable end?
Well, I mean, I'm going to call the word,
what do you call it?
I would call it tan. Everything I see tan, you won't paint it.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. What about the windows?
No, I've done the window trim.
Got
like
it.
A year or two ago, I did them all.
Okay.
Right. And if it doesn't match exactly with the sides, it's okay. No one will know but me.
Sure.
And we did get it, we've gotten one batch since the original paint that the owner left. We've got. Do you want? We have a garage issue too. Would you rather do that, or you want to go up front first and see?
I want to. But let's. Let's talk about the painting quote.
Okay.
And we'll. I'm gonna separate everything.
Okay.
But this is the other end. You want a quote for painting?
Yes.
Okay. And then you mentioned something in the front. Boy, that's a nice gate.
Thank you. Dickerson did it. He did a good job.
It did.
10 years old, but it's still hanging in there.
It is.
We got two big dogs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now you have the front, and everything I see tan that's not a window, you want to quote to paint. Right here.
I don't think the poles need it, unless the paint we get is going to be much different, than it would look horrible. So yeah, I guess the poles, because I've painted them several times, but they have like these.
Sure.
It's got a different material. It doesn't absorb it, you know, the paint just sucks right into it.
Yeah.
Like you touch it and you've got powder all over you.
Sure.
But
yeah.
We replaced our numbers and painted around different areas that had spots and cuts on them.
Sure, sure.
And I believe you did these two end things, didn't you?
Yeah,
honey?
I did.
And then we had to do over here, and so now you can tell it just, we just haven't gotten around to being able to do it all one color.
Right.
But the door I've done and the windows I've done. So
okay, sure.
The only thing would be the poles and this.
The poles in the front, no ceiling.
No what?
No ceiling underneath the ceiling.
No.
Got
I've done that too. That's
got
fine,
it.
And it's not visible from the street. So
okay.
Yeah, and then of course, look at this right here. Even though that's not on my list either, I'm sorry.
What is that?
I don't know if the gutter is bowing or if the shingles are popping up.
Let's see if we
can.
We
do need new gutters.
Yes. Let's see if we can put a support in the middle of the gutter.
That would be great.
Yes,
thanks.
Ma'am. Sure.
And then what about this, honey? That you fixed before?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. This list is growing. And
that's
growing.
All right. It does. It does.
I did some repairs here.
Sure.
This one, we had a windstorm or something.
Sure, sure.
We come home, the gutter was off, and me and my brother reattached it best we could. And I'm not a carpenter.
Sure.
But we need some work on this.
When it rains, this is where it comes, and it just, you know, but it's not caused any structural changes with the ground or anything, but it just pours out like crazy, and it looks like some of it might be rotted.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Can't tell, don't know if it just needs the gutter to be flushed to the fascia. I don't know.
Well, one of the things, gutters, they need a slope. If you look at the fascia on the left side, that's the area under the gutter.
Right.
There should be less fascia than there is up here. So the water runs downhill.
Right.
And I'm not sure if there's what they call a back drain, but it looks like you got about 2 inches on the front side, 1 inch on the left. So it looks like it's a reasonable slope.
Right.
Yeah, we tried to get the slope the best we could. I put that back, and like I said, I'm not an expert
by no means.
And we tried to get it so it would drain out.
Yeah, we didn't know if we needed another downspout like our neighbors do right there or what, but it.
Well,
I don't think it's a problem. I
will make a suggestion that there's a calculation that engineers do. You think about that much roof, all the way down to the midpoint of your portico, coming back in, and all of this area is covered by that one gutter.
Right.
So that in a big rain, I don't know that it has the ability to handle that much water.
That might be it. It just overflows.
So that, you know, here again, if your neighbor's got a similar condition with the geometrics.
They have two downspouts. Yeah, one by on the left and then one right next to his car on the right.
Sure, sure.
And then he's got another one on the end.
Right.
And they do too. They have one on either side.
Right.
But anyway, just...